Hey everyone, it's Ivan with KitBadger.com here today for a first look at some new stuff. We'll go ahead and start with this guy. I got this in from Chase Tactical. If you're not familiar with them, they make all kinds of tactical gear. In addition to that, they sell a lot too, like on their site, other manufacturer stuff as well. But this one in particular, there we go. Boom. Plate carrier. And to go with said plate carrier, somewhere in all this bubble wrap, set of ballistic plates, level 4 standalone. So I'm gonna go ahead and throw these guys in. Alright, carpe diem, it's time to seize the day. I will say, nice, low profile, slick plate carrier. Their plates, it seems like they might be a little bit of a proprietary cut, I'm not sure, but they fit well in the plate bag. There's a little bit of room up top, probably made so that like your e-sappies or anything will fit in there, basically a wider range. Pretty thin here through the shoulders. I'll need to adjust it, bring this up a tiny bit, but yeah, room for mags on the sides. I'll be spending more time with it. Which brings us to this box from Brownells. And yes, since I already have this plate carrier on, it'll probably just stay on for a bit. Economy of motion. But I talked to the guys over at Brownells. And I was like, hey, I was wondering if maybe I could try one of your rifles. And they were like, we can make that happen. So, we got this guy. Retro. Let's see if we get in here. Too many boxes. Bam. Well. I'll be honest, this thing kind of feels like a toy, but it's crazy. Just the old school plastic and stuff. All right, we're gonna try this thing out. Right back here, I have the Runenation Cold Start, which you can run with a pistol or you can run it with a rifle. I have one 20 rounder from Brownells. I have a couple 20 rounders from Ammunition Storage Components, Minuteman Munitions 55 grain, and we're gonna run the Cold Start. For it, you basically jam up 2 magazines of 8 and then a third magazine full and you go after it. One round in a low probability target, 3 in the large, in the circle in the middle basically. Do that twice, conduct a reload, twice again, make up shots as you need it, part time at 18 seconds. So I'm gonna jam these guys up, get some ear pro on, grab my pro timer, some eye pro, which is gonna be dark glasses because I forgot my clear lenses, and we'll get after it. All right, let's do this thing live. Kinda wish I brought my clear lenses. Not that it'll matter. Here we go. Ooh. Man. That was pretty slow. And definitely did not make part time. 27.01. Took me a little while to find where this was shooting, but oh well, we'll take a look at it. Out the gate, I knew I was gonna have offset issues. I obviously haven't zeroed this thing, but I knew there was gonna be offset at 5 yards. So I was holding somewhere up here. My first round dropped in there. I was like, damn. But I went straight over to the high probability. 3 rounds here, held up probably about there, broke the line there. 3, conducted reload. Up here, got in there. 3, again up here, broke the line there, even if just barely. 3, and then I was out. So I had to conduct that last reload, held up. Too high, dropped there, brought it down some, dropped there, final shot. As I mentioned, 27.01. Just missed it by about 9 seconds. But I'm gonna go ahead and get this zeroed, probably at 50, do a little more shooting. All right, let's go ahead and do this thing for reals. Down there, I have a TA Targets Reduced B C-Zone Steel Silhouette. All right, do you even retro? No big deal. For being honest with ourselves, we're probably asking ourselves the exact same question right now. Where the hell is my bayonet? Good question, working on it. But this is my first look at this new slick plate carrier by Chase Tactical, as well as this Brownell's retro rifle, M16E1, old school. So as I get more time with both of them, bring you guys full reviews. And as always, thanks for joining us at kitbadger.com. Look forward to seeing you next time.